So Mitch McConnell finally recognized that Joe Biden and Kamala Harris have won the 2020 election and are president-elect and vice president-elect. There's no doubt in anyone's mind anymore, anyone reasonable, and Mitch McConnell has finally jumped on that train. But just because he's done that, conservatives are losing their goddamn minds and they're furious at him. I want to play you his statement, and then we're going to come and break it down and make it clear that Mitch McConnell does not deserve one iota of praise.
President Trump and Vice President Mike Pence deserve our thanks and our gratitude for their tireless work and their essential roles in all these victories and in many more. 6 weeks ago, the Americans voted in this year's general election. The legal and constitutional processes have continued to play out since then. Yesterday, electors met in all 50 states. So as of this morning, our country has officially a president-elect and a vice president-elect. Many millions of us had hoped the presidential election would yield a different result. But our system of government has processes to determine who will be sworn in on January the 20th. The Electoral College has spoken. So today I want to congratulate President-elect Joe Biden. The president-elect is no stranger to the Senate. He's devoted himself to public service for many years. I also want to congratulate the Vice President-elect, our colleague from California, Senator Harris. Beyond our differences, all Americans can take pride that our nation has a female Vice President-elect for the very first time. I look forward to finishing out the next 36 days strong with President Trump. Our nation needs us to add another bipartisan chapter to this record of achievement.
So look, there's going to be a certain instinct for some libs out there to be like, oh my goodness, thank you Mitch McConnell for finally recognizing the election results. And I don't want to hear any of it. I don't want to hear it. He was not one of the few Republicans that, you know, in the day after, 2 days after the election, called Joe Biden, put something out on Twitter, put something out to the media saying, you know, we recognize that Joe Biden has won. Maybe we didn't support him, but we recognize that he'll be our next president and we wish him well. He was not one of those people. Mitch McConnell was one of the crucial elements in Donald Trump's effort to undermine the election. Mitch McConnell maybe never came out and fully endorsed what Trump was doing, but through his silence and through his insistence that, you know, the Electoral College vote ultimately is what determined things, that gave people permission, especially in the Senate, but also in the House, to go absolutely crazy and effectively try and undercut Joe Biden during his transition. And let's be perfectly clear that Mitch McConnell is a goddamn hypocrite, because last time in 2016, he recognized Trump almost immediately. He was one of the first people to recognize Trump in 2016. He did not wait for certifications. He did not wait for the Electoral College. He was immediate in recognizing Trump, even though that election was an identical 306 Electoral College win and Trump lost by millions of regular votes, whereas Biden won by 7 million plus. So if the election was actually close, maybe you'd have an excuse, but it wasn't. So Mitch McConnell is a hypocrite. But none of this matters, despite the fact that he bent over backwards to allow Trump to undermine democracy. Republicans are losing it at him. I'm just going to throw some tweets up on the screen. I don't want to read some of them because they're vile in some cases. But what you can see is everything from Mitch McConnell, because he has an Asian American wife, is secretly in the pocket of China. Mitch McConnell is deep state. Mitch McConnell is a bigger threat to Republicans than Joe Biden and the Democrats. Mitch McConnell's a rhino. Mitch McConnell sold us out. Mitch McConnell is a traitor to good, you know, real values conservatives, all because he recognized the result 6 weeks after most people in his position, including himself 4 years ago, recognized results. And all I want to say is this: You deserve this, you SOB. You deserve this, you heartless, cowardly ghoul. You deserve this. No sympathy for Mitch McConnell. No praise for Mitch McConnell. Mitch McConnell is one of the most evil men in Washington, and he deserves this. He deserves nothing less than to be railed upon by the monsters he helped to create and legitimize and give power. Yeah, these people existed before Mitch McConnell and Trump. Yeah, these people were always around. These ghouls were always around. But Mitch McConnell, in his lust for conservative justices and rich people tax cuts, gave Trump and his cronies all of this power and made a deal with the devil. And now that Trump is on his way out and Mitch McConnell seems to want to, you know, wipe his hands clean of Trump and his, you know, reckless base, it's too late. They now have a substantial foothold in the conservative movement, in the Republican Party, in right-wing media, and you can't get rid of them, Mitch. They are here to stay. They might not be as powerful with Trump out of office, but they will be there always, challenging you. And as John Harwood notes from CNN, this will have immediate consequences, not only for the Republicans in the Senate, but potentially for Mitch McConnell's own personal power. He tweets the following out. He says, Barr had no choice but to recognize reality. No major election issues and whatnot. Now he's out. Mitch McConnell had no choice but to recognize Biden's win. He did so after Vladimir Putin, for context. He'll soon find out how selfish and destructive Trump wants to be. By sinking Loeffler and Perdue, Trump could put McConnell out of his job too. Mitch McConnell won his Senate seat easily because the Democrats ran an awful candidate against him instead of Charles Booker, but his real power is vested in the fact that the Republicans control the Senate. Make no mistake, in many ways, Mitch McConnell over the last 10 years has been the most powerful conservative in the United States, even more powerful than Trump, in his ability to stymie Democrats in the Senate and usher through legislation in the Senate. Mitch McConnell is incredibly powerful. You don't always hear about this turtle-looking MF-er, but he's very powerful. He's very powerful. And if he loses these two runoffs, he doesn't have that power anymore. It'll be 50-50. The tiebreaker will go to the Democrats, and likely the next Senate majority leader will be someone like Chuck Schumer. He's not great, of course, but he's better than Mitch, and Mitch will be just one regular senator from Kentucky, just one of 100, nothing significant. And he doesn't want that. Mitch McConnell wants his power. And so the great irony here is he sold himself out to Trump for power, and now Trump could be the one to take power away from him, because it's Trump and his supporters and these ridiculous people at OAN and Newsmax basically saying, look, man, I don't know about Georgia. You know, if they took it from Trump, they could take it from Loeffler and Perdue. The best scenario might be to not participate at all and just sit it out. And if enough conservatives do that in a race that close, it could queer the election for them. Mitch McConnell deserves nothing less than this embarrassment. Mitch, you sowed, and now you're reaping, and I love to see it.